Growing up, one of my favorite toys was Lego. I collected a lot of the sets, I would always get them as gifts and build the things in the kits. And then when I got tired of them, I would deconstruct them and store all of the pieces in these giant Rubbermaid bins. At various points, I would then get inspired to make my own creations. And this required rummaging through all of these bins to look for very particular parts because I had an idea of what the model should look like in my head. And of course, I needed that one piece in a very specific color, and I knew I had it, and I knew it was in one of these bins, and it would take me untold minutes, maybe 15, 20, 30 minutes to find these pieces. A lot of times, I would get frustrated during this process and call for help. In this case, it was usually my mother. Mom, help me, I can't find this piece. And my sweet mother, she would stop whatever she was doing, walk into my room, sit down with me, and look for 15 to 20 minutes sometimes for this one piece. The funny part is, she was often better at finding them than I was, whether it was just she had better eyes, she knew what to look for, or we had two sets of eyes, I don't know, whatever it was, she would often find them before I did. And apparently, spending 15 minutes to look for a particular brick in a pile of Lego pieces was not unique to me. Last year, Lego announced the Find My Brick app as an April Fool's joke. The implication, of course, was that something like this couldn't be done. Well, I did it. Okay, it's a rough proof of concept. It still needs a lot of work and tweaking to make it into something useful, as you'll see in a minute here. I'm not an app programmer, so I used whatever I'm most familiar with, and that was a microcontroller. This is an OpenMV H7 board running MicroPython with an LCD shield. The first limitation is that this project only works at a very particular distance away from the pile of Lego bricks. The second is that the lighting used to capture images to train the neural network needs to be more or less the same lighting used in deployment. As you can see, the field of view is quite small, but it's enough to prove that I can identify individual bricks. There are three main parts to any machine learning project. First, you need to collect data, and this is usually lots and lots of data. Second, you need to train your model, or models, you might have more than one. And third, you deploy your system, which includes your model or models. To collect data, I made a simple camera that would capture a bunch of images and store them onto an SD card. I wanted to use the same camera sensor, lens, lighting, and distance for data capture as I would for deployment. I connected a simple button to the OpenMV module that I could press to take a photo. OpenMV has a really slick IDE and API that lets me whip up some MicroPython code very quickly. All this program does is capture an image and store it as a bitmap file to the SD card whenever I press the button. Here's the next limitation. I wanted this proof of concept to be able to identify one particular brick. That means all this effort was spent having the system learn what that particular brick looked like. And it means that it's unable to identify other bricks at this time. I chose this gray, flat, round 2x2 plate as my target test piece. Next, I set up my pile of bricks with my camera positioned about 8 inches directly overhead. I then take a photo of this pile that does not include the target piece. Next, I put the target on top of the pile at some location. I continue to move the target around, taking photos each time. This is where more limitations come in. Because this is a rough proof of concept, I only trained the system to recognize the plate when it's face up and on top of the pile. It does not recognize the piece if it's partially covered or in a different orientation. I repeat this process with different piles so that the target has different backgrounds. I then copy all the files to my computer into a dataset folder. I open each photo containing the target piece and crop out the piece, keeping the resolution the same each time. 32 by 32 pixels seems to work well enough for this demo. All of these cropped photos of the target piece are saved in another folder. Ideally, they should provide the neural network an idea of what the piece looks like in different locations and with different lighting. If I wanted to train a more robust model, I would take a lot more photos with a greater variation in lighting and put the piece in different positions, such as on its side, upside down, and partially obscured. This might require hundreds or thousands of photos, and I don't have a way to do that automatically. While we have a bunch of photos of the target, I need to collect photos of things that aren't the target, basically all the other Lego pieces. I took a few photos of the pile without the target piece, which will make life easier. All I need to do is divide these up into 32 by 32 chunks. So I wrote a quick Python script that does exactly that. I'll run this and check the output folder. I should see a bunch of 32 by 32 images of various Lego pieces that do not contain the target piece. This should be enough data to get a simple preliminary system working. If I was building a real system or an app, I'd want to collect way more data than what I've done here, but this is just a proof of concept. To train our neural network for the OpenMV camera, there's a great online tool called Edge Impulse. Note that Edge Impulse does not work with bitmap images at this time, so I use a tool to quickly convert all of my images to JPEGs. To use Edge Impulse, I sign in and create a new project. Let's head to Data Acquisition and upload all of the 32 by 32 JPEG images. I'll do the target and background images separately and let Edge Impulse automatically divide them up into training and test sets. From there, we make an impulse, which is their term for a data pipeline that extracts features and trains the model. Note that I need to set the image width and height, as it seems that Edge Impulse can do some scaling or cropping if needed. We'll set the processing block to image and use a neural network. It defaults to MobileNet, which is a great pre-made neural network for identifying images. However, it's a bit too large for our microcontroller, as it's really meant to run on things like smartphones and single board computers. So I'll use a custom neural network instead. Let's save and head to the image processing step. I'll tell it to generate some features from the images, which, from what I can tell, are just the raw RGB values for each pixel. This might take a few minutes. Then we can train our neural network. I recommend spending some time playing with the various layers, as it's really cool to build a neural network with a graphical tool like this. I found that two layers of 16 convolutional filters worked well enough for my purposes and was small enough to fit on the microcontroller. I also like to change the number of training cycles to 100 so that it will train for longer. I'll then tell it to train and then wait a minute or two. When it's done, we can inspect how it performed on the validation sets. The accuracy measure might be misleading, so I recommend looking at the confusion matrix to see if it's doing a decent job of correctly classifying our images. Then we head over to model testing and try out the model on the test set. I like to make sure it's correctly classifying at least 50% of the target pieces. Ideally, this would be more like 90%, but for a proof of concept, this is good enough. Finally, let's go to deployment, where Edge Impulse will wrap all of this up for us to download, specially made for the OpenMV platform. If I unzip the file, I should see the TensorFlow Lite model file, a text file containing the labels, and some starter MicroPython code. To install these onto the camera, all I need to do is copy the model file and labels text file to the OpenMV drive. Note that because I have an SD card in the OpenMV, all of this will be stored on the SD card, and the MicroPython program will run from there as well. Let's open the MicroPython code and copy it. In the OpenMV IDE, let's create a new program and paste in the example code. This is a good place to start, but it has a few issues. To make this work, we need to first capture an image and then crop out a 32 by 32 pixel chunk. We perform inference on that chunk by running it through our TensorFlow Lite model. That will tell us if it thinks the chunk contains the target piece or not. We then shift the window over by a few pixels and repeat the process. We do that for the whole image. When it's done, it will highlight any areas that it thinks contain the target piece. This is a brute force way to look for an image. I'm sure there are better, faster ways to accomplish this, such as filtering by the target piece's color, but this method should work well enough for now. I modified the example program so that it takes a photo when I press the button and then searches through that image to identify areas that might look like the target piece. One cool feature of this IDE is that I can run it on the camera module from my computer and see what the camera sees. Let's add the target piece into the field of view of the camera and press the button to take a photo. The LED will flash to let me know it's about to take a photo and then stay on when it's processing that photo. It should take about 10 seconds, but when it's done, the photo should appear in the frame buffer pane of the IDE along with any areas it thinks contain the target piece. As you can see, it's far from perfect, as I get some false positives. I also get some false negatives pretty regularly, in that it will miss the target piece altogether. The LCD is pretty small, but it makes the device portable. let's scale the image down and display it onto the LCD. I'll also deploy it onto the OpenMV so that it can run without being connected to my computer. Now, when I press the button, it will highlight the piece for me on the LCD. The box is a little hard to see, but that's a feature for version 2. As I mentioned, this thing is full of bugs and not all that useful. However, I do think it shows that a Lego brick finder could be made. It would just require a lot more effort than what I've done here. Here's how I envision it working. Lego, or a third-party site, would keep a database of all available Lego pieces, and each piece has an associated machine learning model. An app on my phone would allow me to pick which piece I'm looking for, and then the app would download the model for that piece from the database. I could then use the phone's camera to look at the top layer of my pile of bricks. Each frame would be scanned, similar to my method, and if the target piece is found, the app would highlight it on my screen. Ideally, you would collect more data to construct more robust models and then run the thing on a faster processor, say in a smartphone. This app, in theory, would allow you to identify individual Lego bricks in a pile more quickly under a variety of lighting conditions and at a variety of distances. My code for this project can be found in a link in the description if you'd like to use it as a starting point for your own project, say making a Where's Waldo solver. Please subscribe if you want to see more videos like this one, and as always, happy hacking!